All right, so let's make sure that we get this concept. So let's evaluate tit for tat versus tit for tat, spy versus spy, and ask whether or not they are subgame perfect or in a subgame perfect equilibrium with each other. And your choices are yes and no.
Mm-hmm.
But if you say no, I'd like you to give me a sequence to show that it is not subgame perfect. In other words, that if they were to take this sequence of actions, and this one was to take this sequence of actions, it would leave the machines in a position where they would not be willing to follow through on their threat, that it would be better for them to do something else in the long run, assuming that they're still playing against the other tit-for-tat machine.
From that point on.
Yep.
Just imagine that someone could go in and change one thing. Would you still want to follow tit-for-tat the next time step or not?
Yeah, I don't know that it has to be just one thing, but yeah, that's right. Change the sequence leading up to this point and then say, okay, do you still want to do what tit for tat is telling you to do, or would you rather do something else?
Right. Okay, I think I got it.
Cool. All right. Go.